Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 2 Thessalonians 1:1-5. Paul, Silas, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace and peace to you from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We ought always to thank God for you, brothers and sisters, and rightly so, because your faith is growing more and more, and the love all of you have for one another is increasing. Therefore, among God's churches we boast about your perseverance and faith in all the persecutions and trials you are enduring. All this is evidence that God's judgment is right, and as a result you will be counted worthy of the kingdom of God, for which you are suffering. Today's title is Suffering Worthy of the Kingdom of God. There are people who think that Christians believe in God to have a comfortable life. As a pastor, I believe that's partly true. Who would not want comfort or peace in life? Like everybody else, all Christians have the same desire for comfort and happiness in life. We cannot deny it. And I believe that God would not rebuke us for having such desire. As a matter of fact, God has clearly told us that He wants to give us such joy and happiness in life. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy, I have come that they may have life, and have it to the full. John 10:10, however, believers are not to seek or chase the comfort and happiness of life only. Comfort and happiness on earth should not be the goal of a believer's life. Jesus clearly showed the purpose and priority of a believer's life. He said, "But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." Matthew 6:33. Seeking His kingdom and His righteousness is the primary goal of our life. And we often have to go through suffering when we seek His kingdom and His righteousness. Therefore, suffering as well as peace and joy is an essential part of Christian life. People with genuine faith do not shun suffering. They rather boldly go through the suffering. Thessalonians who were relatively new Christians had to go through suffering. They had many persecutions and trials. But they endured and persevered in faith through all the persecutions and trials. On hearing such steadfastness of Thessalonians in the middle of sufferings and trials, Paul, Silas, and Timothy, who worked together to preach the gospel for Thessalonians, were all greatly elated and sent this letter in one accord to encourage the Thessalonians. They said that such endurance would make them counted worthy of God's kingdom. I believe that's how God would view our perseverance and endurance in heaven too. He would count our suffering to keep the faith in the middle of hardships and to glorify God as worthy when we stand before His judgment throne. Are you suffering? Are you in trials? Rejoice and persevere. That can make you counted worthy of God's kingdom more than anything else.